He's all I need. He's all I need. Jesus is all I need. He's all I need. He's all I need. Jesus is all I need. And surely today he is all that we need. Praise the Lord. I want to preach a little bit today out of a familiar scripture. Praise the Lord, or portions of it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's found in the third chapter of St. John's Gospel, the 16th verse. Very familiar verse. You probably wouldn't have to turn to it. You probably know it verbatim. Most of the church does. Praise the Lord. But I want to preach a little bit, praise the Lord, on salvation. Praise the Lord. The price that Jesus paid on the cross of Calvary, that you and I may be redeemed from this world. The Bible says in John 3:16 that God so loved the world, hallelujah, He so loved the world, not this earth, not the trees, although He made them. World, He's not talking about. He's talking about mankind. He's talking about those men and women that He made in the garden. He breathed into their bodies the breath of life, and they became a living soul. But they was made out of the dust of the earth. That was Adam and Eve. But they fell, and therefore we needed a Savior, praise the Lord, to bring us back into fellowship with God. Hallelujah. That we can have fellowship one more time like Adam and Eve did in the garden. Praise the Lord. At one time in the garden, God would come down in the cool of the evening and He would walk with them. He would talk with them and possibly give them instructions on how to do this or how to do that. I don't know what they talked about. But praise the Lord, He would come down in the cool of the evening and talk with them. But after they sinned, after they were driven out of the garden to live in the earth, to raise their own food, to bear children, we are cursed with the curse of sin when we are born. Hallelujah. What the Bible says that we must know first that we are a sinner. We must realize that we are a sinner before you can get saved. You've got to realize that you are lost without God. You've got to realize that there is a heaven and there is a hell. You've got to realize, hallelujah, that the life of sin that you're walking in has to be taken care of, that you can be redeemed back to God, hallelujah, that once again you can walk in the cool of the evening with God. God will walk with you. Maybe not, you won't see Him, but He will walk with you in the cool of the evening, and you can commune with Him again, hallelujah, because, hallelujah, Jesus, God's only begotten Son, praise the Lord, not His only Son, not His one and only Son, but His only begotten Son, hallelujah, was the supreme sacrifice that you and I and everyone that was born of woman, born into sin because of what Adam and Eve did, can be redeemed back to Him. Hallelujah. So first of all, you've got to know whether you're living right or not. And you don't know, the Bible will let you know. The Word of God will let you know. Hallelujah. You can't do what you want to do. You can't live any way you want to live. Hallelujah. If you've never called out to Jesus Christ, if you've never given your heart unto Him, if you've never called out to Him, praise the Lord, then you are a sinner. Now, found out that you're a sinner. I had to find out I was a sinner. There was a time I didn't know Jesus Christ. I was raised in church, Pentecostal church, from the time I was 6 years old. But I didn't realize the enormity of it. I didn't listen, you might say. If I would have listened, praise the Lord, I might have grasped it at an earlier age. But, hallelujah, I came to the place where I knew that I was a sinner. I knew that if I died in the condition that I was in, I knew of a surety that I was going to bust hell wide open and I was going to be tormented day and night the rest of my life throughout eternity without end. When I came to the realization that I was a sinner and I needed a Savior, then I began to listen when the preachers preached. I began to look in the Word when I got a chance to see what I could do to rectify what I was doing. I found out that I just couldn't go and be a good man. I found out that I just couldn't do works because it's not of works lest any man should boast, but by grace through faith in Christ Jesus, we are saved. So I found out, hallelujah, Romans 2 and 23 says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Hallelujah. We had all sinned, but we were born of a sin nature. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We are born into sin. And we need a Savior who is Jesus. Hallelujah. He came down. God sent His only begotten Son down that you and I might be redeemed from this earth, that you and I might be redeemed, hallelujah, unto Him, that we might live forever in heaven one of these days. He came down. He paid an awful price. We just went through the period of the crucifixion, the burial, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We just went through that season just last weekend. We find, hallelujah, that Jesus had to die on the cross of Calvary that you and I might be able to call out upon Him. For the Bible says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. There's no other way that you can get saved except through and by the blood of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. There's no other way to salvation. Jesus shed His blood on Calvary that you could be saved. There's no other way. No other God. No other one you can pray to. But you've got to bow down at the foot of the cross of Calvary and call out to God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That Jesus, hallelujah, His blood might wash away our sins, that we may be made righteous and holy through Him and His Word. He gave His only begotten Son. Hallelujah. People said, well, I thought they was one. They are in agreement. I had two sons. But I'm the father. And if I would say to one of my sons, you go over there and get something for me and bring it back and give it to me, I don't go, but I send my son. I don't leave my position where I'm at. And that's what it was. God did not leave heaven, but Jesus came down, was born of a virgin in a manger. Hallelujah. From the beginning of time, before the creation, God had this plan, for he knew man would sin. There's only one way, and that's through the blood of Jesus Christ, that we can be saved. Hallelujah. He gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe upon him shall be saved. You must believe that he is the Son of the living God. Then you must believe that he died for your sins. Then call out upon God, and he will save you by the blood of Jesus Christ and wash your sins away. Hallelujah. And then make you a child of the living God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are born of the Spirit. We are born of the Spirit of God. First time we were born, we were born of a woman. There's a saying that says, he who is born twice dieth once. But he that is born once dieth twice. Think about that. The first one, he that is born twice, the first time from his mother's womb, the second time by the blood of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, then should he go by the grave, he will die one time. Because when the resurrection takes place, he will go to be with the Father in heaven. And his glorified body that comes out of that ground, hallelujah, will be eternally with the Father. So he's only going to die once. But he that is born once, just born of a woman, but is not born again by the blood of Jesus Christ, he will die in this world, and in hell he will die forever, which is the second death. Hell is the second death, where the fire quencheth not and the worm dieth not. The Bible calls hell the second death. Hell is hot. It's enlarging itself every day because men and women refuse salvation, which Jesus paid for on Calvary, and go their own way, and they're headed straight for hell. Hell was not prepared for man. Hell was prepared for the devil and his angels before man was even created. Man was not supposed to go to hell. But the Bible says that hell hath enlarged her borders because man chooses to go there. You have to make a choice. You have to make a choice. Though millions have come, there's still room for one. There is room at the cross for you, that you may be redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, saved, sanctified by His word, and filled with the Holy Ghost to walk upright before Him in this world, that we may live with Him in the next. Oh, hallelujah. He was crucified for our salvation. His word has been given to us to sanctify us. Sanctification is just pulling away from the world and leaning upon God. Separating ourselves from the things of the world and letting God have full control of our lives. Not our will, but your will done, oh Father. That's what Jesus prayed. Not my will, but your will be done. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You don't have to live in torment in this world. The devil will torment you. But you can be set free by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And the blood of Jesus Christ will wash your sins away. And the Holy Ghost will destroy every yoke of bondage that you have. Hallelujah. The Word will sanctify us, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Word will justify us. It will sanctify us. Hallelujah. It will separate us from the world. It'll change us. It'll take out that old man, kill that old man, and put on the new man that might be pleasing unto God. This is what God expects from each and every one of His children, to walk upright before Him. Not only did He die on the cross of Calvary for our salvation, but the Bible says, as we had last weekend, the Bible says on the third day, early in the morning, the rolled stone was rolled away, hallelujah, with the shaking of the earth, hallelujah, and Jesus came forth for our justification. You are justified by His resurrection. Romans 4:25 says, who was delivered for our offenses, and was raised again for our justification. We are justified by His resurrection. We are justified, hallelujah, to live for Him. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We are. He came out of the grave. We are justified to live in His righteousness, not our righteousness. Our righteousness is as filthy rags unto the Lord. But we got to take on the righteousness of God. The Apostle Paul said, have this mind in you that was in Christ Jesus. What are you going to miss by getting saved? What are you going to miss? Sickness? hard times, troubles, trials. You'll have all of these with no one to help you. Finally, in the end, when death comes to you, the Bible says, where the tree falleth, that's where it'll lay. Whatever state you die in, that's the state that you will be judged in. Hallelujah. God has given every man an opportunity. He's given every woman an opportunity. He's given every boy an opportunity. He's given every girl an opportunity. Hallelujah. To call out upon Him. Hallelujah. That the blood of His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, can wash your sins away. Praise the Lord. But as I said before, the choice is yours. You've got to make the choice. I had to make the choice for myself. My wife had to make the choice for herself. My children will have to make the choice for themselves. I can't do it for them. They were given a freedom. Hallelujah. By God. Gave them a freedom to choose life with Jesus over here or death in hell over here. It's up to you. It's up to you. Not only did He pay for our salvation, there is healing in the atonement for your physical body. Isaiah 53:5 says, for He was wounded for our transgressions and bruised for our iniquities. And the chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and with His stripes we are healed. Hallelujah. You'll have the privilege when you give your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ. Then you'll have the privilege when you get sick and doctors said they can't do nothing more for you. He'll not only be the Savior, He'll be your healer. He says, I'm the Lord God that healeth thee of all thy diseases. This healing, Jesus told them, hallelujah, that healing was the children's bread, and it wasn't meat to give it unto the dog. I've heard people say, well, I was a sinner and God healed me. God showed mercy on you because somebody that could touch your throne, hallelujah, was crying out to God for you. It doesn't save you. Maybe God healed you. But if you're still a sinner, you'll take that healing to hell with you. He bore the stripes on His back for the healing of the bodies. He bore the stripes on His body for your healing. Child of God, if you're sick and you're a child of God, you're washed in the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, and you're doing everything that you know to please Him, and you're walking according to His word, that you had the mind in you that was in Christ Jesus to walk upright before Him, hallelujah, then you have the right to go to Christ. You've got a right to call out upon God for your healing, no matter what it is. He's the Lord God that healeth thee of all thy diseases. Not just one of them. Any disease known to mankind. Jesus died and He bore the sins for that sickness and that disease. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Salvation is for the sinner. healing is for the child of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You've got to make a choice. This day, it's either heaven or hell. What's it going to be? I told you the Bible says that hell enlarges its borders because man chooses to go there. I believe that pocket of hell that was made for the devil and his angels, I believe it was right in the center of this earth that we call earth. Now, I said, I believe this. This is what I think. And over 6,000 years that man's been on the earth, huh? Oh, come on now. Hallelujah. Over 6,000 years man has been on the earth. And in those 6,000 years, billions upon top of billions upon top of billions of people have went to hell. And even as I'm speaking now, people are dying and going to hell because they refused the death of Jesus Christ on the Calvary's tree for their sins. Now, to encompass all of those souls that are in hell tonight, today, crying out, but they'll never get any peace. They'll never get any relief from the flames of fire until they come out of hell and they are stand before the white great white throne judgment. When they're standing before the great white throne judgment, then they will be judged for the sins that they did in their bodies, and they will be cast back into the hell, back into the fire, and they will stay there for eternity, never to get out again. You've got a choice if you're still living. If you're watching this program, you've got a choice. You can fall down on your knees right now, wherever you're at watching this. And you can call out upon God. I'm going to pray. In a little while I'm going to pray for those that need salvation. I'm going to pray for those that need a healing. Hallelujah. Jesus wants to save you. He wants to heal you. Praise the Lord. If you'll call out on Him. Call out upon Him. As I offer prayer for you. Hallelujah. I thank and praise God that one day I made up my mind. I made my choice to follow Jesus. To follow Jesus and none other. To do what He would have me to do. Go where He would have me to go. Preach what He would have me to preach. I believe that hell has enlarged itself, and that's why we're seeing the earthquakes in a lot of places. That's why time is running down. Hallelujah. It's because the inside of the earth has eroded by fire. Oh, my, 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 my. I'm going to pray for you right now. you that are on your knees, you that want salvation, I'm going to pray that God will save your soul. You pray with me. Praise the Lord. And you that need a healing, I'm going to pray that God will heal you too. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we pray, Lord, oh God, that one that is on their knees right now. Oh, Father, those that are calling out to you right now for salvation. Lord, I pray, God, that the blood of Jesus Christ, hallelujah, would wash their sins away, and you and Jesus come in and take up your abode in their heart. Oh God, that you might walk in them, that you might live in them, that you might keep them, hallelujah, in your ways. Father, I pray for those that are sick and afflicted. I pray, Lord, this day that you would touch their bodies. Father, your children reaching out right now, heal them by the stripes on Jesus' back. Deliver them and set them free. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Whoa, glory to God. Raise your hands and praise the Lord, would you? Praise the Lord, just right where you're at. Just raise your hands and thank Him for salvation. Thank Him for healing. Thank Him for deliverance, amen. Hallelujah. He said if you'll call upon Him in a time of need, He said He would hear your cries and He would deliver you out of your bondage. He's all that you need. He's all I need. He's all I need. Jesus is all I need.